The Philippines is undergoing a massive infrastructure boom, with billions of dollars being invested in new roads, bridges, airports, railways, and other infrastructure projects. These large-scale projects aim to transform the country by improving connectivity, reducing travel times, boosting economic growth, and enhancing the lives of Filipinos. In this video, we will look at 10 of the biggest ongoing mega projects in the Philippines and examine how they are changing the nation. New Manila International Airport. The New Manila International Airport, located in Bulacan just north of the capital, is the most ambitious project in the Philippines' infrastructure drive. This massive airport aims to be one of the largest in the world, with 4 runways, capacity for 100 million passengers annually, and sprawling over 2,500 hectares. To put its scale into perspective, it will be bigger than major hubs like Beijing Capital International Airport, Dubai International Airport, and New York's JFK. Built at an estimated cost of $10 billion, the New Manila International Airport is a testament to the Philippines' aviation aspirations. With Ninoy Aquino International Airport in Manila facing maxed-out capacity, the New Manila International Airport will provide much-needed relief for overburdened infrastructure and establish the Philippines as a global transfer hub. It is also expected to generate over 1 million construction jobs and 100,000 permanent airport jobs, a major boost to employment. As the country's largest public-private partnership project, the Department of Transportation is collaborating closely with project lead San Miguel Corporation to bring this vision to life by 2025. The New Manila International Airport will propel Philippine aviation into the big leagues and open new gateways to the world. Metro Manila Line 9. Metro Manila Line 9 will be a rapid transit line connecting Manila proper to Ninoy Aquino International Airport. Traveling 24 kilometers through Manila with 13 stations, Line 9 provides direct airport rail access to the capital's central business districts. As one of Metro Manila's new railway projects, Line 9 will help address the metro's notorious traffic congestion. With capacity for 1.2 million daily passengers, it will get commuters to the airport swiftly while reducing the number of cars on EDSA and other major thoroughfares. The line is forecast to cut travel time from Manila to the airport to just 35 minutes. Integrated with a Metro Manila Transit network, Line 9 will interlink with other lines like Metro Manila Line 1, Metro Manila Line 2, and the planned Metro Manila Subway. This interconnectivity enables convenient transfers and accessible public transportation across Manila. The Department of Transportation is constructing the 50 billion peso Line 9, while the Light Rail Manila Corporation will handle operations upon completion in 2028. Line 9 forms a key component of the metro system's expansion and demonstrates the Philippines' commitment to upgrading rail infrastructure. With world-class airport accessibility, Line 9 puts Manila on par with major global cities in terms of connectivity, mobility, and livability. Malolos-Clark Airport, Clark Green City Rail. The Malolos-Clark Airport, Clark Green City Rail project will connect Malolos to the Clark International Airport and the emerging Clark Green City development through an elevated 39-kilometer railway. The new railway aims to enhance connectivity between Manila and Central Luzon while fostering economic growth. With capacity for around 1 million daily passengers across 9 stations, the railway offers direct links between Malolos, Clark Airport's growing aviation hub, and Clark Green City's emerging CBD north of Manila. The enhanced connectivity provided by this railway will support business, trade, and tourism across the region. The rail project is a collaboration between the Department of Transportation and the base's Conversion and Development Authority. The Philippine National Railways will operate the railway upon completion in 2025. By seamlessly connecting across Bulacan, Pampanga, and Tarlac, this railway contributes to an integrated transportation plan for Central Luzon, focused on airport rail mobility. Combined with the New Manila International Airport, Clark International Airport's expansion, and Clark Green City's rise, Central Luzon is being transformed into a thriving economic zone. Revitalized rail infrastructure like the Malolos-Clark Airport, Clark Green City Rail Project provides efficient regional access and demonstrates the Philippines' commitment to modernization. It brings Central Luzon closer to Manila and enables the region to flourish. PNR Long Haul Project. The Philippine National Railways, or PNR, Long Haul Project aims to revive, store, and expand the Philippines' nationwide passenger railway system. Through a three-phase process, it will rehabilitate existing lines, construct new lines, and enhance services across Luzon. Phase 1 focuses on renovating current provincial PNR services to improve safety, reliability, and efficiency. Phase 2 entails new railway construction, including the North-South Commuter Railway, connecting New Clark City to Calamba and the Metro Manila Subway. Finally, Phase 3 involves upgrading and extending neglected PNR services like to Legazpi and Dagupan. The 100 billion peso project is restoring the once prominent role of rail in Philippine transportation, a role diminished by underinvestment and neglect. With long-haul service connecting regions, the enhanced PNR will provide accessible and affordable transit options for Filipinos nationwide. The PNR long-haul project demonstrates the Philippines' seriousness about revitalizing the outdated railway system to boost mobility and connectivity. It aims to increase ridership from less than 200,000 currently to over 1 million daily passengers. The government views rail as vital to economic progress. Led by the Department of Transportation, the PNR long-haul project embodies the infrastructure renewal envisioned under the Build, Build, Build program. By modernizing rail transport, it brings the Philippines one step closer to becoming a prosperous, globally competitive nation. Bohol-Leyte Link Bridge. The Bohol-Leyte Link Bridge will be the longest bridge in the Philippines at 2.1 kilometers. Connecting the islands of Bohol and Leyte across the Bohol Strait. This bridge holds major significance for linking two main islands in the Visayas region. Currently, sea travel between Bohol and Leyte takes over 3 hours. The bridge will reduce travel time to just minutes, providing easy access for tourism and commerce. As a landmark crossing, the bridge can handle 2,000 vehicles per hour with a 50-meter clearance for ship passage underneath. The 26 billion peso project is being constructed by the Department of Public Works and Highways. The bridge requires an extremely long span due to the deep strait waters between the islands. Once completed, it will be a new focal point for the Visayas, similar to the Marcelo Fernan Bridge in the north. Beyond simply connecting Bohol and Leyte, the bridge will integrate municipalities across the strait like Ubay, Maasin, and Hindang. This will facilitate trade, generate new economic opportunities, and boost tourism. The Bohol-Leyte crossing opens the door for the islands to cooperatively develop as Visayas hubs. As a symbol of connectivity between major Philippine islands, the visionary Bohol-Leyte Link Bridge project will bring communities closer together and spur progress. It represents the country's drive to use infrastructure to unite its over 7,000 islands. Cavite-Laguna Expressway. The Cavite-Laguna Expressway, or CALAX, is a new expressway under construction that will link Cavite and Laguna. Spanning 47 kilometers with 10 interchanges, this four-lane toll road will handle 100,000 vehicles per day and cut travel time between the two provinces to just 30 minutes. The 26 billion peso project is being built by Cavite's Infrastructure Corporation, a subsidiary of Metro Pacific Investments. CALAX will provide a high-speed alternative to congested roads like the Manila-Cavite Expressway. By improving connectivity and accessibility between Cavite, Laguna, and Metro Manila, CALAX will facilitate economic growth in the Calabarzon region. South Luzon Expressway Extension. The South Luzon Expressway Extension project will connect SLEX to CALAX. This 13-kilometer elevated expressway includes two interchanges and will carry around 50,000 vehicles per day. The extension provides a direct route between SLEX and CALAX, improving connectivity between Metro Manila, Cavite, and Laguna. The project is being constructed by the Department of Public Works and Highways. Costing 5.4 billion pesos, the SLEX extension will alleviate traffic and bottleneck issues for vehicles exiting SLEX towards Cavite and Laguna. It is a crucial linkage between two major expressways in southern Luzon. Subic-Clark-Tarlac Expressway. The Subic-Clark-Tarlac Expressway, or SETEX, connects Subic Bay to the Clark Freeport Zone in Pampanga Province. This 93-kilometer expressway with 13 interchanges serves as a vital route between two economic hubs north of Manila, with capacity for 100,000 vehicles daily. SETEX was constructed by the Basis Conversion and Development Authority at a cost of $390 million. The highway provides easy access between Subic, Clark, and Tarlac, facilitating trade and supporting Central Luzon's economic development. SETEX also connect to the North Luzon Expressway, enabling efficient transit between Manila and northern regions via expressways. Davao City Bypass Road. The Davao City Bypass Road is an 18-kilometer highway currently under construction that will serve as an alternate route to bypass downtown Davao City. With four interchanges, the four-lane bypass road will handle around 50,000 vehicles daily to alleviate traffic within Davao City proper. The project is being constructed by the Department of Public Works and Highways at a cost of 15 billion pesos. By providing a high-speed route around Davao City, the bypass will ease congestion and improve travel times for both passenger and freight transport passing through Davao del Sur province. Panguil Bay Bridge. The Panguil Bay Bridge will span Panguil Bay between Taob City and Ozamiz City, connecting the provinces of Misamis Occidental and Lanao del Norte in Mindanao. The 5.4-kilometer bridge is the first cross-sea bridge in Mindanao. With capacity for 2,000 vehicles per hour, the bridge will promote economic development and integration in northern Mindanao. The 25 billion peso project is being built by the Department of Public Works and Highways. The Panguil Bay Bridge is considered a crucial piece of infrastructure that will boost tourism, agriculture, and trade across Misamis and Lanao. It will also improve accessibility between cities like Tangub, Ozamiz, and Iligan. Mactan-Cebu International Airport Upgrades. The Mactan-Cebu International Airport Authority is implementing a major expansion program to develop the airport into a world-class regional hub. The 17 billion peso project involves construction of a second runway and terminal plus cargo facilities. With upgrades doubling passenger capacity to 12 million and cargo capacity to 200,000 metric tons annually, MCIA will boost tourism and economic growth for Cebu and the Visayas region. The gateways to the beaches of Cebu. Mactan-Cebu International Airport continues to elevate the Philippines as a top global destination. The Philippines Infrastructure Drive demonstrates the nation's ambition to build world-class transportation networks and uplift the economy. Roads, railways, airports, and bridges that facilitate connectivity and accessibility are rising across the archipelago. These mega projects are modernizing the country and setting the stage for increased trade, tourism, and prosperity. While overcoming development challenges, the Philippines perseveres with its visionary Build, Build, Build program. From Manila's bustling metro to the islands of Visayas and Mindanao, high-impact infrastructure is building a brighter future for the Pearl of the Orient Seas. Thanks for tuning in. Make sure to like and subscribe.